have all been selected by your peers or the public. I don't think any bosses this time nominated, which is kind of nice, because it's nice when it's the people that you work really closely with and members of the public that nominate you for this. So the SOAR award basically means that you've done your job well, and in most cases have gone above and beyond what most people think is really necessary for your job. And hopefully that happens every day in Alamance County, and you all are being recognized for that today. So we're just going to get started with reading the nominations.
So I think we have two commissioners here with us today, our chairperson Amy Gailey and Commissioner Bob Byrd. I'd ask them to come up and read the nomination forms that were submitted by either the public or your peers. So we only have a small number, so if you both would like to do that, that'd be great. This is the final?
No, these are, I've got it right here.
Okay,
I'll put it right there.
There's a reason why we're wearing blue today.
Yeah, we're not going to do that.
Please, we left a little center stage for you. Is there a reason?
It's bring out child abuse month, and so we went to the event at the courthouse. And the theme color is blue.
There's some blue pinwheels around, and that's what those are.
Yes, so go by and check out the courthouse.
And Brian was there too.
Yes, and thanks to Buddy's folks, the courthouse will be blue this evening, so if you drive around the square, it'll be lit up in blue, look very nice. Thank you, Buddy.
That's the county thing?
Yes.
Oh, because the...
They said Bramley. Yeah, wrong.
Always. Under the radar, but we know who that is.
Everybody in this room knows there's a difference between the city of Graham and the county of Alamance, right?
Yes.
So, Carol Wood, is she here? Carol Wood, public health nurse, Alamance County Health Department, is being recognized for excellence during the third quarter. Carol helped me understand everything needing to be done to get ready for birth. Not me. Providing me with information on where I can go to get help with what I needed. If she didn't know the answer, she would find the answer. She deserves the award because she is a great person. She was understanding, knowledgeable, and professional.
Carol, you're coming up. They'll get a picture of you with chairperson and commissioner. Congratulations. Now, you go right up here. Scott will get your picture. Middle one. Congratulations.
All right, this goes to Stephen Massey, program analyst in the IT department.
He's not here.
Well, I'll go up. Should I read this? I should read this.
Yes.
Since late 2016, the times have been a changing for Stephen. Stephen had a part in the implementation of Kronos, our timekeeping software. He's also had a major part in the implementation of Munis. The finance department went live with Munis July 1st, 2017. Since then, Stephen's days have been filled with all things Munis. Imagine. I'm sure he dreams of bank reconciliations and voided checks at night. On top of this, Stephen has been working to implement the new HR payroll module for Munis. Am I saying that right, Munis?
Yes.
Payday January 2018 came and went. Well, we all knew about it from the emails regarding changes. My bank account didn't know there were any software changes, which meant everything went smoothly. Thank you, Stephen, for working tirelessly to learn and implement a new software smoothly, ensuring payday happened. Very important.
Right. Alicia Tanner, she's a public health nurse with the health department. Alicia was professional and listened carefully when she was taking my information before my physical. She was so personable and informative. I love the way she communicated with me, informed me of everything I asked, and even had me crack a smile when these visits aren't the most pleasant. Thanks for making me smile, Alicia. Thank you.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Okay, Sherry Ward, IMC 1, Alamance County Social Services. Sherry, since I've been living in Alamance County, she has been an angel. Since I've been here, she has given me several resources, encouraging words, and prayers. She is awesome and a breath of fresh air. It was also noted that Sherry listened well and clearly went above and beyond the call of duty. Sherry.
I'm getting all of you in this.
I'm going to do this in money.
Thank you.
Okay. Terry Lamb.
Thank you.
Terry is the office manager at the library. Terry is the hub of our Alamance County Public Library wheel. She receives the most diverse and unusual requests on a daily basis from staff, businesses, agencies from the public sector, as well as within Alamance County government agencies. And she places all on the top of her list as important and worthy of her care and attention. We're not going to put you on the spot and ask you what's the most unusual or diverse request you want to see. Terry is always helpful with finding resources, items needed for programs, and information. Even when she's not certain, she will try her best to find answers and report what she has found in a timely manner. I don't know what Alamance County Public Library staff would do without her. Thank you.
Okay, great. So we have two employees sharing the work while each gets their award. They're mentioned together. Scott Devian. Devian? How do you say your last name, Scott?
Devian.
Devian. And Emily Baum, both from the landfill. And a customer to the landfill stopped in the office to compliment Scott. Quote, the customer, Dean Coleman, said he is a regular and a former county employee. Mr. Coleman said that Scott presented himself well to the public and was very helpful unloading a large, heavy object. He said that he wanted the director and his supervisor to know how great Scott is and for it to go into his personnel file. Mr. Coleman was impressed with the professionalism that Scott displayed and how willing he was to help. He said that Scott really seems to enjoy his job. And then further quoting, then after further conversation, he said, I could add my name to the list too. Says Emily Ball.
So that's just a copy for each of
you. Oh, okay. So, these are, so Emily's, but they each get a certificate. Okay.
Concerning tax regulations and requirements for Alamance County. Our county is very fortunate to have her working in this department. She is very courteous and professional. Come on.
Gabriel Ware, Local Worker 3, ESS. Where's Gabriel?
Yes,
there she is. Come on. Getting ahead of myself. Although I do not work in the same program area as Gabriel, there is a couple I know outside of work who happen to be one of Gabriel's former foster families. who later became adoptive parents. I usually see this couple 2 to 3 times a year at various events, and the first thing they ask me since they know I work at DSS, is how is Gabriel doing? Does she still work there? She's such an awesome champion for families, end quote. So after the 8th or 9th time of this happening, I asked them if they were okay with me sharing their words on Gabriel's service. And this is what they had to share. Gabriel Ware was the caseworker for the 2 children we ended up with adopting a couple of years ago. From the time we met her, we were impressed with her honesty, clarity, kindness, and compassion. She made sure that all of us involved in the process had a good sense of what was going on and what the possible outcomes were. She supported everyone in the process, from the babies to the birth parents to us, while never losing sight of the fact that her ultimate priority was the most vulnerable people in the system. All foster care placements are complicated stories at some level. We wish everyone involved in any placement had the kind of support that Gabriel Ware provides.
Rhonda Moracle, did I say the last name? Finance specialist with the finance department. Since late 2016, the times have been changing for Rhonda. Rhonda weathered the implementation of Kronos, our new timekeeping software, and quickly became an expert. In September-October 2017, she began working on another implementation, Munis Payroll. She has put in long hours both at the office and remotely during snow days while sick, etc. Payday January 2018 came and went. While we all knew about it from the emails regarding changes, my bank account didn't know there were any software changes, which meant everything went smoothly. Thank you, Rhonda, for working tirelessly to learn and implement a new software while continuing to use the old software and ensure payday happened once the new system was in place.
You guys tell the same person nominated Stephen. Thank you. And this is our man.
Thank you.
And she's not here. So it's going to be accepted for her, and we'll get a picture later.
Okay, great. Did y'all hear that? So she's not here. The winner is Melissa Terrell, T-E-R-R-E-L-L. Terrell or Terrell?
Terrell.
Melissa Terrell is a tax appraiser in the tax department. Melissa is an all-around team player. She repetitively helps in our PUV department and helps all citizens with the utmost respect and professionalism. Recently, when one of our co-worker's family member passed away, she took it upon herself to complete the co-worker's work, said to assist with a deadline without a disturbance in the workflow within our department. She also got a second nomination, which said, I'm a co-worker that witnesses Melissa's professionalism, work ethic, eagerness to assist taxpayers, and ability to address appraisal issues on a daily basis. She is often asked to fill in wherever needed and never hesitates to help anyone who asks. She assists us in the PUV office with clerical duties, answering our phone calls and general questions to satisfy taxpayers until we can return their calls. She often has to put aside her work to help other co-workers with their work, and does so without hesitation. In regards to taxpayers, she goes above and beyond assisting folks, taking extra time to explain and completing forms, as well as addressing other issues. She has often stayed after hours and through her lunch to do so. On one occasion, Melissa waited for an elderly taxpayer who couldn't get to the office to submit a particular form by the deadline of 5 p.m. because of a hardship, and made certain the form was completed and processed. Melissa is extremely patient, even when taxpayers are difficult or belligerent. Might be that way, and can diffuse the situation without conflict. I feel she is an asset to this office, department, and to Alamance County, and therefore deserves this award.
She
wanted to be here, she could, she would be.
Great. Well, tell her thank you so much for her, for us.
Absolutely.
To her, for us.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Great. Well, we certainly appreciate having Chair Daley and Commissioner Byrd here with us today. Thank y'all so much for taking the time to be here. It means a lot to us as employees, and on behalf of Alamance County Management, I'd like to tell each one of you thank you. Thank you for the great jobs that you do, and it's very special to be recognized by your peers and by the public. You should feel very proud of yourselves for the work that you do, so thank you very much. And I don't know if Chairperson or Commissioner Byrd would have any other comments to make. So
I think we need one more round of applause for everybody.
Well, I'd just like to say thank you to everybody for what you do. I'm just so proud to be working with such professional people, really on the front lines doing the work of government. Those of you who are working directly with the people of this community, and then also to you that help those people working directly, doing all the behind the scenes support that's so very much necessary and important. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.